A single dirty shoe is enough to introduce Panama disease tropical race 4 onto your property. Managing the movement of people on and off your properties is an integral part of keeping the disease off your farm. The best way to manage people and the risk their footwear poses is to exclude all external footwear from your farm. This means having dedicated footwear available for exclusive use on your farm by staff and visitors. A number of growers have developed innovative systems for managing the movement of people and controlling use of footwear on their farms. The Mackays are managing their footwear by dividing their farm into different zones and having different coloured gumboots and footbaths in these zones.
People have come in, or the workers, they're wearing their normal boots. They are asked to take them off and they place on white gumboots, and the white gumboots then are through a dip and then they're into our yellow zones. The yellow zone is the shed zone. If they're going to go outside the shed, they go into the green zone, and they'll have to go through another dip with their white boots again, which are basically clean, go out into the green zone and change to black boots, which obviously can get very dirty.
At Sarah Farming, they have an innovative way of managing footwear.
We set this up as a cheap and effective way of a boot change station for all visitors and workers that come to the farm. Open at both ends so you can walk in one end and have a door that seals off to the outside, change your boots, and it's open on the other end as well, and it also allows for boot dips on both ends, in and out. Yeah, so the foot bath at each end, the reason for that was double security, I suppose. So people come in, there's a bench here to sit on. They sit on the bench, they take their outside shoes off and put them on the bench on the right. Then they swing around, grab their numbered boots from the left-hand side, the farm shoes, and put those on. They then pass through the boot dip on the way out to the farm. So each person that works here and visitors, the people that work here and the regulars, they have a numbered boot that is theirs every day. It's their size. We issue them to them when they start. And visitors also have visitor boots.
Matt Abbott also has a simple and effective way of managing footwear.
If people need to come into the farm, they come in through the front door, below the entry sign, and up to the concrete wall where they take their town shoes off and flick their feet over and put gumboots we've provided to wear inside the shed. Where the shoes are kept, the shoes are down on the bottom two rows, and the top row is for anyone bringing bags in, so the bag doesn't touch the floor. They put the bag on the top rack, take their shoes off, flick their feet over, put their work gumboots on, and then they can grab their bag so the bag doesn't come in contact with the floor.
In addition to changing footwear, the installation of foot baths to disinfect footwear adds another layer of protection. However, there are some important aspects to consider to ensure they are effective. Use gravel or some other hard surface at either end to help remove dirt from footwear. Have available a firm bristle brush so that visitors can remove excess dirt from footwear before entering the foot bath. Ensure the foot bath is long enough to walk through so that footwear must make contact with the bath solution. Also ensure that the sides of the foot bath cannot be walked on so that all visitors must walk through the foot bath. Physical barriers can also be used to prevent staff and visitors from walking around the foot bath. And also ensure disinfectant solution is changed regularly to maintain its effectiveness. Remember, it only takes a single dirty shoe to introduce Panama disease tropical race 4 onto your property. Introducing simple, easy to follow systems such as dedicated footwear and footbaths are important for managing the risk of spreading the disease now and into the future.